تمام. طيب let's start our lesson كتاب التوحيد chapter 44. clear؟ تمام. What is the name of the author of the book? The book that we are using now. What is the name of the author, sisters? Without reading. Anyone knows the name of the author? Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. This is not the author of the book. Our book is the concise commentary. Yes, صالح الفوزان. Yes, الشيخ صالح فوزان. دكتور صالح فوزان. Okay. كتاب التوحيد is محمد عبد الوهاب is the author of who wrote كتاب التوحيد. But our book is the الملخص by الشيخ صالح فوزان. Okay. تمام. الحمد لله. We got the answer. Yes. دكتور صالح الفوزان فوزان. There is another شرح for الشيخ صالح الفوزان كتاب التوحيد. This is one volume. He has another sharh, two volumes. And that book, wallahi, very nice. I like that book, mashallah. But I did not see the translation. I did not see the translation of the other one. I don't know if it is translated, but for me, I did not see the translation. طيب. Chapter 44, page 347. باب من سب الدهر فقد آد الله. باب من سب دهر فقد آذى الله. Inveighing against the vicissitudes of time wrongs Allah. طيب من سب الدهر. To insult the time. Okay. You insult a day. You insult a month. You curse it. He said آذى الله. You are bothering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Let's see what we have in this chapter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he mentioned the ayah. وَقَالُوا مَا هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرُ. And they say there is not but our worldly life. We die and live, and nothing destroys us except time. And they have of that no knowledge. They are only assuming. طيب. خلاص. خلاص بس بديت. خلاص خلاص. خلاص تبي تسمع؟ مشكور. بس شوفي ماي. طيب. وقالوا ما هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا. This saying from the kuffar. Page 347. This ayah from the kuffar, about the kuffar. They are called al-dahriyun. Al-dahriyun. They believe in dahr. Dahr is the time. They believe that this is from the time. Okay. Mark. Okay, this is because of the time. Because my marriage was on Wednesday, so that's why it was spoiled. The marriage was in the month of Shawwal, okay, it was successful. Okay, because of the time, we succeed or we fail. This is haram. This is haram. Okay, if you following the Sharia, okay, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is needed. This is our job. I follow the Sharia. In the Sharia, nothing, for example, regarding marriage, nothing about to marry on Wednesday or Thursday. Because there is a belief that, no, you should avoid marrying, doing the nikah on Wednesday. This is haram. Okay, this is haram. Why? Because we don't have proof to avoid Wednesday in marriage. Yes, we have about fasting. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned about fasting Friday alone. Yes, we have a hadith. Don't fast Friday alone. When he say, saw his wife fasting Friday, he asked her, have you fasted Thursday? No. Are you going to fast tomorrow, Saturday? She said, no. Then the Prophet said, don't fast Friday. Okay, yes, there are details about that, but generally. طيب. So the Dahriyun, what they say, Dahriyun from the word Dahr, the time. They say this hayat, this life, ما هي إلا أرحام تدفع وأرض تبلع. This life, it is wombs pushing the baby outside, which means pushing that baby outside. وأرض تبلع, the earth absorbing us. It means the janazah. We bury the person. This is life. Birth and death, birth and death. So they don't believe in the hereafter, and this is haram. And they believe this life has a control, has an effect on the person, the days, the months, okay? And this is haram, no doubt, and this is like insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. And if we notice what they say, وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ. And they say there is not but our worldly life. We die and live. This is haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gives life, and he causes a person to die. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلِ اللَّهُ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكُ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ تُنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah raises people up. Allah puts people down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the victory for people. It makes people to lose. Allah gives the kingdom for some people. Allah takes it from other people. Allah makes people to live, to die. It is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. He mentioned hadith عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عن hadith in page 349 that Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah says, قال الله تعالى يؤذيني ابن آدم يسب الدهر وأنا الدهر قلب الليل والنهار. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says the son of Adam wrongs me, يسب الدهر, insults me, for he inveighs against the vicissitudes of time, though I am the one who manages time and I cause the alternation of day and night. In another narration, it is related that the Prophet ﷺ said, don't inveigh against the vicissitudes of time, for Allah is the one who manages time. Bukhari and Muslim. طيب. First of all, this hadith is called Hadith Qudsi. Hadith Qudsi. Like, يعني, a holy hadith. How we know the Hadith Qudsi? When you see the beginning of the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that Allah said, قال الله. Okay, and yeah, you will find the scholars mentioning the difference between the hadith Qudsi and the Quran. طيب, so Allah says in this hadith, يؤذيني ابن آدم. يؤذيني ابن آدم. The son of Adam wrongs me. طيب, here we should be precise. There is أذى and there is ضرر. أذى, يعني for example, if I am sitting like this and there is a fly, okay, during the class, for example, I have 1 hour class, and there is a fly. The fly comes here on my, this is called غترة. So I try to remove this. Then it comes on my nose, I do like this. It comes on my hand. So what you say? This is fly. It is يؤذيني or يضرني. Those who knows Arabic. This is أذى or ضرر. Sisters, what do you think? أذى. Okay. This is أذى. What is the translation of أذى? Annoying, yes. Something annoying me, bothering me. This is adha. Because if there is a fly, it is coming here, there. طيب, no, I will not say harm. I think annoying, يعني. Maybe more precise, annoying. It is annoying me, bothering me. Okay? Because this fly will not cause me يعني injury here or bleeding or causing the person to be blind. But this is bothering the person. I will continue the class. Okay, irritating me. something like this. Yes, because I will continue the class. Do you think that if there is a fly, okay, I'll tell you, sisters, please, there is a fly making trouble for me, I will not continue the class? We will not say that. We will not say that. Or for example, يعني, if the temperature is يعني hot, maybe the AC is not working very nice. So I will continue the class. Yes, it is bothering me, the hot weather, but I will continue the class. This is called أذى. طيب, ضرر, what is your ضرر? ضرر, no, there is, it is not a fly, it is a mosquito. Maybe two, three mosquitoes, and one of them came here. Then it is sucking my blood. The other one came the other side. It caused يعني pain here, and or bees. So they are stinging me here and there, okay, causing some trauma here, there. So this is darar. This is darar. Why? Because I need medicine, and I will not continue the class. I will leave the masjid. Or I will call someone to help us to kill these mosquitoes who are bother or harming the people. Okay, so this is the difference between adha and darar. Okay, so maybe adha as translation, bothering, annoying, disturbing. Darar, it is harming, to cause a harm. You got it? Tamam? I hope this is clear. Because here the translation wrongs Allah. I don't think that this is a correct translation. Why I'm saying that? Because يعني if you know the difference between these two words, you will understand the Quran and Sunnah. Allah says in the here in this hadith, what you'll find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proved, affirmed that there can be adha, that people can make adha for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. صح? Okay? Adha can be done. طيب. Can we say people can cause harm? No, never. Can cause darar? Never. Why? Because in the other hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, hadith Qudsi, إِنَّكُمْ لَن تَبْلُغُوا ضُرِّي فَتَضُرُّونِي. You cannot reach to a level to harm me. So people can make adha for Allah, but they cannot make darar. Never. You got the point, sisters? I hope this is a clear point. This is important. Clear, sisters, or confusion? Clear? Kazma, she said clear. I need two, three people to say clear. Or should I repeat? Tamam. Okay, so now you got the difference between adha and darar. So adha can happen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes. When people speak these words about the time. Can darar happen to Allah? Never. No one can cause darar. No one can harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you read in the Quran, Allah says about the kuffar toward the Muslim, لَنْ يَضُرُّكُمْ إِلَّا أَذَى. Okay, you know, this is like a glad tiding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the believers. لَنْ يَضُرُّكُمْ إِلَّا أَذَى. You know, when the hypocrites speak and they try to spread the rumors. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said they cannot harm you except bothering you, annoying you. For that situation. So here we come back to the hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the son of Adam wrongs me. Or let's say, bothering me, annoying me. Okay. How? For he inveighs against the vicissitudes of time. Though I am the time. And I cause the alternation of the of day and night. يؤذيني ابن آدم يسب الدهر. Okay, I'm causing, for example, today is off, Saturday is off, okay, and we plan from the morning. I told my wife and my children, let's prepare for a picnic. The weather is nice in Kuwait, alhamdulillah. Nowadays it is relatively nice. يعني the temperature it is 33, very nice. ما شاء الله. In the noon time 33, 34, 32. ما شاء الله. This is very nice. At night it is 27. ما شاء الله. Very nice. So we decided to we plan to go on a picnic. Okay. So we prepare the things. So from the morning, okay, when I want to start the car, it is not working. Okay, then I went here to the garage to fix the car, so I wasted maybe 2 hours. The plan is to leave home at 10, so now we are leaving the home at 12. So when we drove the car, we started, okay, there was a car accident. So this made us late for another 1 hour. Okay, when we reached to the place, it was full, no space for us. So what a bad day. Okay, this is not our day. This is astaghfirullah. This is qadarullah. It is haram. You insult the day. This is qadarullah, the decree from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you don't know, maybe this is good for you. Being late or not to find a place in that garden or farm, maybe this is good for you. So it is haram to insult. Why? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah said, وَأَنَا الدَّهْر. Okay, I am the time. I am time. Like here, what is the meaning? The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah said, I am al-dahr. Does this mean al-dahr is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No. It is not one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because if you continue the hadith, what you will find? أُقَلِّبُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ. Okay? I am the time, which means the one who manages time. And I cause the alternation of the day and night. Okay, so this is the meaning of the hadith. There are scholars who say that Dahr is one of the names of Allah. Yes. Or what is known that Ibn Hazm, rahimahullah, said this is one of the names of Allah. But other scholars do not agree with him. They said, why? Because the Prophet ﷺ in the hadith explained what is the meaning of that statement. I am the time. Which means I cause the alternation. The other narration, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا تسبوا الدهر. فإن الله هو الدهر. Don't inveigh against the vicissitudes of time, for Allah is the time. Which means the one who manages time. So, what is the point here, brothers and sisters? Now, maybe we are wondering, what is the relationship between this chapter or this hadith and Kitab Tawheed? What is the Tawheed of this point? The Tawheed of this point now, when we insult the time, I insult Monday, or I insult the month Shawwal, or I insult this year, or this date, anything from the time, what is the point? As if you believe that the time has an impact, the time can change the things. And this is haram, this is a kind of shirk. You should believe that Allah, everything in the control of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you should not insult the time. Why? Because the time is one of the creation of Allah. Allah created the time, Allah created the place, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay, Allah created everything. So what is the point when you insult or when you curse the time, the sun, the moon? As if you are cursing the creator of these things. So you should control your tongue and you follow the sharia. You say alhamdulillah, you say qadar Allah ma sha fa'al. Okay, if there is something wrong. And you should not insult the time or also the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, we go to the next chapter, 45, page 351. التسمي بقاضي القضاء ونحوه. Names such as the judge of judges and the like. في صحيح نبي هريرة رضي الله عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن أخنع اسم عند الله رجل تسمى مالك الأملاك لا مالك إلا الله. قال سفيان مثل شاهن شاه. وفي رواية أغيض على الله يوم القيامة وأخبثه. قوله أخنع يعني أوضع. Meaning of the hadith. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said the most awful meanest name in Allah's sight is that of a man called King of Kings. Malik al-Amlak, King of Kings. For there is no sovereign but Allah. La malika illa Allah. Who's the real owner of everything? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He owns everything. The real owner subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sufyan is one of the narrators. He's tabi'in. He's not a companion. One after the tabi'in generation. He said, such as the name of Shahan Shah. And another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most abominable and evil man in Allah's sight on the day of resurrection. Here, what is the point here? The Prophet ﷺ said, this is the worst. King of the kings. Where is the Tawheed here? The Tawheed that, if you remember, with the beginning of the book, we explained what are the types of Tawheed. What are the types of Tawheed? Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, Tawheed al-Asma al-Sifat. What does mean Tawheed al-Rububiyyah? That to believe that Allah is the only Lord. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he created everything, and to believe that Allah has actions, no one can do these actions, to give rain, to give life, to cause death, and to change the weather, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is rububiyyah, lordship of Allah. Uluhiyyah, our actions should be toward Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-asma' wa-sifat, okay, asma wa sifat, names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned previously, to believe that Allah has names and attributes, no one has the same. And we should believe in these things without changing, without imitating or resembling Allah with His creation. This is very important. So when you come here and you say, wallahi, this man is the king of the kings, this is haram. Because the king of the kings, Allah, Malik al-Muluk, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here the author said in the title, Qadi al-Qudat. The hadith, okay, the hadith talks about king of the kings. But the title, judge of judges. Why? Because the same concept. The same concept. You should not say Malik al-Muluk. You can say this person is the king of this country. The king of Kuwait, the king of Saudi Arabia, the king of UK, the king. Haram? Not haram. Okay, the Qadi of Kuwait, the Qadi of UK, the Qadi of Egypt, Qadi means the judge. Haram? Not haram. But when it becomes haram, when you say, this is the king of the king, the king of the kings, haram. Why? Because Allah is the king. And also, this is the king of this country. This is Allah, but king of the kings, their leader, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or Qadi al-Qudha, also this haram. But can I say king of the kings of a certain area? Okay, you keep it limited. This is allowed. But when you keep it general, haram. It is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do I mean? For example, in UK, let's say you have many cities. Okay, or United States, you have many states, and every state there is a king. So I say this person is the king of the kings of the states. This is allowed. Why? Because you kept it limited for this area. Or he is the judge of the judges in Kuwait. Okay, this is allowed. Why? Because you made it clear as specific for Kuwait. So when we should avoid? When you keep it general. The Qadi al-Qudha, the judge of the judges, this is haram. The king of the kings, this is haram. Because who is the king of the kings? Allah, subhanahu, only Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, we should not raise people to that level. We should keep them up to their level. You are a king of the country, okay. You are the judge of the country, okay. But king of the kings, judge of the judges, you should avoid that. And like Shahan Shah, okay, they use this word, they mention this word in Persian. It means also king of the kings. Shahanshah, it is a Persian title. So now the issue, it is not only the exact word, the meaning. If you are using in your language, in English, in Persian, in France, and Dutch, whatever the language, okay? Also it is haram, it should be only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So again, what is the relationship between this chapter and Kitab al-Tawheed? Because this is one of the Tawheed that you should respect the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only for Him. You should not use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people. If you remember, we mentioned this, وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ وَلِلَّهِ Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. For Allah, the highest names. Invoke Him by these names. وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَاءِ. And leave those who are making ilhad, those who have deviation in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the deviation and the regarding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for others, this is haram. This unique name or special name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because there are names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be used also by people. Okay, when we go to the next chapter, chapter 46, reverence of Allah's beautiful names. احترام اسماء الله سبحانه وتعالى وتغيير اسم لأجل ذلك. Respecting the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and changing the names of Allah سبحانه changing the names of the person to respect the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. He mentioned here one hadith in this chapter. أبو شريح رضي الله تعالى عنه أبو شريح رضي الله تعالى narrated, my nickname was أبو الحكم. Okay, what is the nickname here? It means kunya. What is the meaning of the kunya? For example, my name is Ahmed. People call me Abu Abdurrahman, the father of Abdurrahman. So my name is Ahmed and my kunya Abu Abdurrahman. What is your name? Maybe your name is Aisha. And what people call you? People call you Anas. So your nickname or your kunya, Anas. So in Arabic we call this kunya. Also it can be Ibn. Okay, like Ibn Umar. What's his name? His name Abdullah Ibn Umar. What is his nickname? Ibn Umar. And sometimes it is the kunya, it is the name. يعني you'll find some people in the companions or the scholars. What is his name? His name is Abu Bakr, for example. When you check what is his name, it is his name, Abu Bakr. He doesn't have a son called Bakr. He is Abu Bakr, for example, I'm saying. So the nickname, when you put Ab or or Ibn or Ibna. Okay, Abu Huraira, Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdurrahman, or Ibn Umar, Ibn Amr, Ibn, like this. So this is kunya. This is kunya. طيب. So he said, my kunya was Abu al-Hakam. My kunya was Abu al-Hakam. My nickname was Abu al-Hakam. Al-Hakam means the judge. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to me, Allah is al-Hakam. Allah is the judge. And to him judgment belongs. I said, so Abu Shareh explained why people, why his nickname Abu al-Hakam. He said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, when my people disagree about a matter, they come to me and I arbitrate between them and both parties accept my decision. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, how good this is. Do you have any children? I replied, I have Shuraih, Muslim, and Abdullah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, who is the eldest of them? I replied, Shuraih. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then you are Abu Shuraih, related by Abu Dawood and others. And this is one of the things that we like the Muslims to use this way. I mean the kunya. the kunya. يعني many times when the brothers coming to the halqa, but today no one comes. Okay, I'm doing the class here in the masjid, and anyone is welcome to come in the masjid. We are in Kuwait. حياكم الله. You are welcome. If you like to attend, you attend online or offline, you are welcome. So what is your name? Sabil. What is your name? Muhammad. What is your name? Sa'ad. What is your name? Akbar. What is your name? Ali. Okay. It is not common, I notice among the brothers, to use the kunya. Okay. We should train ourselves to use the kunya also among the sisters. Okay. You know, some of them don't like that. No, my name is nice. My name is Zainab. My name is Aliya. My name is Rabi'a. Okay. I like people to call me like these names. Okay. Of course, no problem if you like that. But also, we should not forget this is the way. Even for those who don't have children. Okay. Yani, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called one of the companions. He was very young. Maybe he was 5 years old or 6 years old. He was calling him with a nickname, Abu Umair. Another female companion, she was maybe 1 or 2 years old or something like this. He was calling her Khalid. She's not married. She doesn't have children. She's very young, Khalid. Okay, so this is a kind of respect. We should train ourselves to use this way. Abu Abdullah, Abu Muhammad, Khalid, Ali. This is very important. Okay, this is, yani, I will not say this is wajib. Okay, but very nice, and this is common. Common in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So please, sister, from today, okay, you try to, I will not say this is compulsory, but train yourself. Don't think that you will forget your name. You will not forget your name. People will not forget your name. Yes, sometimes, you know, maybe one of the brothers here, what is the name we call him, for example, Abu Abdullah. So he's with us maybe 10 years. If you ask me, what is his name? Well, I don't know. He's Abu Abdullah. Also, this is wrong. This is wrong. You don't know the name of the person. Okay, because we are using the nickname. Use the nickname and you should know the name. Again, I will not say this is wajib compulsory that you should do that, but we need to practice that this way. Okay, back to the hadith. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to this companion, "Inna Allah huwa al-hakam." Inna Allah huwa al-hakam. Allah is the judge. The companion, Abu Shari, explained why people calling me Abu al-Hakam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam praised him. Yes, this is nice. When you try to reconcile among people, this is nice, this is good, this is one of the great deeds. لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. As we mentioned today in the tafsir class in the morning before 9 hours. The class was before 9 hours. Before 11 hours. Every Saturday I have tafsir class, and alhamdulillah we finished Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Ali Imran, and now almost يعني, we finished more than half of Surah Al-Nisa. And also يعني, there is inshallah this is glad tidings that alhamdulillah there is a project of tafsir al-Quran, the full Quran. Okay, you'll find this in the YouTube channel of Green Lane Masjid by Dr. Ahsan Hanif, mashallah. Very nice tafsir, simple. Okay, I not summarize, nice. Every lesson maybe 25 minutes, something like this. And inshallah, I think every day or every 2 days they will upload a video. The project will be I don't know, maybe 300 lectures or something like this. 300-600 lectures, I'm not sure. طيب. So it is nice that every day you listen to a lecture. طيب. So here, very nice. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ده تفسير باي احسن حيف جرين لين مسجد جرين لين مسجد شانل and my تفسير is on my Instagram also you can find this in my channel YouTube channel احمد الرمحي طيب so ان الله هو الحكم so Allah is the judge Allah is the judge so don't use this name why because this is one of the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and this is one of the attributes of Allah why he said وإليه الحكم here Allah is الحكم and to him judgment belongs so it is not only a name also an attribute طيب here if you check the explanation of الشيخ بن العثيمين رحمه الله he said using the name الحكم is it haram or not haram he said It depends. The meaning of the fatwa of Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen. It depends. If you are using the name Al-Hakam because of the meaning, like this hadith, then it is not allowed. Okay, why you are Al-Hakam, you are called Al-Hakam, or what? Why you are called Abu Al-Hakam? Wallahi, because of the judgment. If you give the same answer like Abu Shireh, then it is haram. But if There is a brother. What is his name? His name is Al-Hakam or Abu Al-Hakam. We ask him, what is the meaning of your name? He said, well, I don't know. He doesn't know. He did not think about the meaning of his name. Then is it allowed? Yes, it is allowed. Why? They say because when you check in the hadith, you will find that some companions, their name Al-Hakam or Hakim, like Hakim ibn Hizam. So that's why they said it is allowed. Or sorry, يعني that's why they said it depends. Why you have the name Al-Hakam, the judge? Is it because of the meaning? Okay, we call you Al-Hakam because the meaning you are doing the judgment? Or it is just a name? It is just the name. You are not thinking about the meaning. You don't know the meaning. So if you are using this name because you know the meaning and the attribute, then we tell you, no, please, you should avoid that and change your name. Because Allah is Al-Hakam. But if, wallahi, you said, wallahi, my father gave me this name. Why? We don't know. Or because one of the companions is named Al-Hakam. What is the meaning of Al-Hakam? Or maybe we know, but we are not thinking about the meaning at all. Then it is allowed. Then it is allowed. So here, what do you notice? Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he did not say haram or halal. He said, it depends. Why you are using this name? If you are using this name because of the meaning, you should avoid. If you are using this name, just wallahi, you like the sound, al-hakam. Okay, because wallahi, all of your children, their name starts with the letter ha. حمد حوراء حيان okay so you like حاء طيب so you gave the name الحكم you went and you checked the dictionary okay or a book of names حاء 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 الحكم يلا what's the meaning I don't know I don't care then this is allowed then this is allowed so this is سبحان الله the importance brothers and sisters to read what the scholars say about the hadith We need the scholars. We need the scholars. Okay, I stop here and inshallah I will give today more time because I think last week we did not give any time for the questions. Today is 21st October. اليوم شو اسمه شنو؟ Take some time for the questions.